opportunity, it doesn't stare you in the face. It's not going to yell at you to come and get it. It doesn't knock. So what does opportunity look like? Not what you might think. You see, opportunity is not a right. It's definitely not equal. And it doesn't come with an instruction manual. That's because opportunity isn't found. It's molded. It's built. It's created. It's as much about grit as it is intellect. An explosive high-tech corridor located at the intersection of muscle and brains? You bet. Because opportunity only comes to those already in the game. What does opportunity look like? It looks like Detroit. Opportunity made in Detroit.
Education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world. Nelson Mandela.
JA really originated with a program called the JA Company Program. And with the Company Program, we would have groups of students come from different schools and go to centers around the Metro Detroit area. And in that situation, the students would put together a business plan, develop a product, and sell that product or service to their family and friends. And that really taught the students about what it's like to be in business, what it means to put together a budget, understand the whole financial piece of that. And since that time, in about the last 15 years, JA really has evolved to be a more in-class program and also has expanded the grade level that we impact with our programs. JA now is in grades K through 12, and so we impact kids all throughout their elementary, middle, and high school lives. And we do that with the use of primarily corporate volunteers that go into the classroom and teach the JA curriculum.
Junior Achievement of Southeastern Michigan. Empowering young people to own their economic success by providing effective, tested, volunteer-driven educational programs to students in kindergarten through high school in the area of financial literacy, work readiness, and entrepreneurship.
Junior Achievement is actually an international nonprofit organization, and we're in several countries other than the United States. In the United States, we're in practically every state in the union, and in I think there's 134 offices around the country. In Michigan, there are 6 offices, and so we all work very closely together to provide programs to every student in the state of Michigan. Pre and post test scores went from 52% right to 72% right on the pre and post test. And the students really understand the life lessons that we want them to. They understand what their parents are going through. They understand how hard it is to put together a budget, what different choices you make in terms of education can make in terms of impacting your net monthly income, in terms of staying in school longer so you'll have a better life and a better income, is really lessons that are driven down to the students when they're here. It's fabulous. We see about 8,000 kids a year come through this facility. I really have a passion for helping children, and I think that Junior Achievement really impacts children and helps them to know what it takes to be successful in life. And I think that is so important for kids to have those kind of skills, to have role models that can show them the way, to learn about being financially responsible. I mean, all the things that are happening in this country, that's such a huge issue that I think that we really need to work on in this city. So I feel very passionately about what we do here and really encourage other folks to become involved with Junior Achievement because it's such a great organization. My name is Karen Kosniewski. I'm the president and CEO of Junior Achievement of Southeastern Michigan. So many people make up JA. I am JA. Are you?
Akibalan Village was founded in 1978 by Marvis Cofield. The organization has built a strong tradition of providing education, wellness, and entrepreneurship programs, as well as other services and activities to thousands of children and teens in this community, and has trained over 250,000 individuals in martial arts. Akibalan Village has received much recognition, including that of being designated as a best practice organization, a national leadership fellowship program.
The village means it's sort of like a lifeline to this community, because we are located in a community where businesses have gone, schools have been closed, churches are no longer able to function. There are no major nonprofits in this community. And so Akibalan Village is somewhat like an oasis in the middle of a wilderness or a desert. And we bring hope, we bring help, we bring empowerment, we bring a spirit of excellence to this community. So that's pretty much what we mean to this community. It takes a village to raise a family.
Kids love being here, parents love bringing them here, and we love to have them here because it's nothing but bad things going on. And they are here, want to be here, feel safe being here. And yeah, we do spoil them here too.
We have a concept called mental, moral, and martial, the three M's. Our founder, Mr. Marvis Cofield, is big on triads. And he speaks in threes, he thinks in threes. And so the triads are really big here. And the mental, moral, and martial is the creed that we operate from. So we've got to prepare our participants and our families to be educated, to be empowered, to think outside of the box, and to be equipped for the real world. And so that's the mental part. So academics is really big here. And we have a high success level because most of our participants, they go to college.
We have trained over 200,000 folks, and we didn't do it for the money. We did it to teach them discipline. Anyone can learn how to kick and punch. It's knowing when to kick and punch and when to walk away.
We are Akibalan Village. It's the only grassroots community organization which we deemed grassroots to global that exists. Some folks should tell me we should be excited and appreciative, and we are. But at the end of the day, it's a sad commentary, because in these days and times, we need more organizations like Akibalan Village. Not, less, but more. So we are not just an east side organization, nor a west side. We provide service to the metropolitan Detroit, southeast Michigan, if you will. And matter of fact, we've traveled all over the country, and matter of fact, I've had the opportunity to go to Africa and provide workshops and build relationships with children in West Africa, Senegal to be exact. So by no means are we just in local, but we have become local, state, national, as well as international.
We're open to give tours for people that really have a real interest in what we're doing and how we're doing it, and get to see up close and personal the programs, the services, and the activities that's actually going on here.
Once again, on behalf of Akibalan Village, we're asking you to give us your time, your talent, and your treasure to help us rebuild our community one brick, one building, one block at a time.
Intelligence plus character. That is the goal of true education. Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.
Detroit Panopticon. Nosh this year is benefiting two great organizations, Junior Achievement of Southeastern Michigan and El Kibalon Village. This is our second year supporting Detroit Panache, and I think it's going to be better than the first.
These are organizations where character is grown, where people learn about the world, life. You're preparing a workforce that I expect to be a part of my business in the future. So being involved with these not-for-profits who's about the development of young people and people is just a plus for me, because when I go into the market looking for people, these are the kind of backgrounds I need from those people to know that they are grounded, they have been prepared, and they're ready to take on the challenges that we have within the company.
When I was in high school down in Texas, and that was a tremendous learning experience for me to get a sense for how businesses, where they come up with money to start a business, and how you run a business, and then how the benefits of that business are distributed to the shareholders, people that provide the capital to the business. And that's a lesson that for somebody that's in ninth or tenth grade really can bring it home what being in business is all about.
Well, you know, one of the things about me is everything that has happened to me, somebody helped me, whether it was my parents, whether it was my brothers, whether it was a friend. So there are no accidents in this world. So it's very necessary that we expose what we have and help other people to also get involved. Helping is just, it's got to be a part of your soul, okay? You got to, and there's plenty of organizations, not necessarily charities, that you can support. And there's enough, if it's your belief, you can enhance your belief by supporting an organization. Junior Achievement is the one that, you know, I truly like. I like the Boy Scouts. All of these organizations that create and develop young people and help them from a character standpoint, it starts them off to get to high school, to college, and eventually to a job. And you find that those kind of people do pretty well.
The mission of Junior Achievement is to teach younger people, kindergarten through 12th grade, about the importance of finance and savings and good financial habits, the type of stuff that typically you don't learn in school. Akeblon's great because it's a beacon in an otherwise a pretty rough neighborhood. There's not a lot in the area where Akeblon is located, at Harper and Van Dyke in the east side of Detroit. And it's many things in one. It's an after-school program for kids, somewhere to hang out during some of the downtime. But they don't just hang out. There's computers, there's homework, there's discipline, there's fun, there's exercise, there's all sorts of good events and activities there.
Kids are our future, and so it's really incumbent on us to support them and to support organizations that provide resources to help children. So that's an important aspect of who we are as a company.
Akeblon specializes in the development of people intellectually. Intellectually, you have to be strong as well as you have to be physically strong, whatever you choose to do or be. So you need to be broad enough to accept what you like and be able to dispense that, let's just say, to a job or to a community or whatever your chosen profession is. So these two entities are extremely important in the growth and the development of our community.
We like to say opportunity is made in Detroit. Opportunity exists here, and you just have to reach out and grab it.
Opportunity, it doesn't stare you in the face. It's not going to yell at you to come and get it. It doesn't knock. So what does opportunity look like? Not what you might think. You see, opportunity is not a right. It's definitely not equal. And it doesn't come with an instruction manual. That's because opportunity isn't found. It's molded, it's built, it's created. It's as much about grit as it is intellect. An explosive high-tech corridor located at the intersection of muscle and brains? You bet. because opportunity only comes to those already in the game. What does opportunity look like? It looks like Detroit. Opportunity made in Detroit.